Hello, my name is Xander. Welcome back to the Python Excel series. In this tutorial, we focus on reading Excel files with openpyxl. In this tutorial, we look at five sections and we build up towards getting our data from the Excel workbook, working with cells or selecting data from cells and multiple values from cells, and then we go ahead and we convert that data into Python data structures. So we'll make the assumption that you already work with Python, or at least you know how to get and start working with Python. So I do have a worksheet here. I've got two sheets, just some data. It doesn't matter, you can use your own Excel sheet for the examples in this tutorial. You will find this in the link in the description, the video description, if you want to download this, as well as all the notes associated with this tutorial. So I'm going to work inside of a virtual environment. So I just go ahead and get that started. So here I'm utilizing Windows. I'm just going to start up a new virtual environment and I'll get straight into that and activate that so that we can go ahead, first of all, and pip install. And we're going to need, obviously, openpyxl. So pip install that. Now, of course, if you are new to OpenPyXL, I do apologize, I haven't explained what it is. So if you haven't seen the first tutorial, you won't know that OpenPyXL is a Python library, which has all the tools readily available for us to hook into so we can start reading and writing and performing actions on our Excel file sheet. So this is what we're going to be utilizing. This is what we've just installed. So let's go ahead and have a look. Completely optional, but I'm going to go ahead and create a new file called example.py. I'm going to work from here. So OpenPyXL, a library, a resource we can hook into. So let's go ahead and first of all, let's from OpenPyXL, let's go ahead and import the load workbook. So this is going to allow us to load workbooks. There's no surprise there. So let's go ahead now and utilize this. And we're going to open up the Excel file sheet. You can use file name equals, you don't need to. So my Excel file is called example.xlsx. Now it is in the same folder structure here. So I don't need to do anything special here other than type in the name and the file extension of this file. So this will work with other file extensions. Go ahead and have a look at the repository and the documentation. You'll see that we can work with different file types. That might be worth mentioning. Okay, so now we've loaded our workbook in. We can go straight ahead and let's just go ahead and print the workbook so we know that it's worked okay. Let's go ahead and run our file. And here we go. So here we have an object that's been returned, suggesting now that we have actually prepared or we've loaded our workbook in and we can now start working with our workbook. If you head back to the Python package index page for OpenPyXL, head over to the home page, that takes you to the documentation. Now, if you have a look through specifically at the load workbook function, there are a few different optimized modes here that we have, for example, read only and write only. And that might be some use for you at some point. It'd be well worth having a look through at the different parameters for the load workbook when you have a little bit of time. So now we know a little bit more about loading the workbook, a few different parameters that we have available, for example, read only, write only, data only, for example. So let's go ahead now and actually perform some simple operations here, getting used to some of the information that we have at hand now. So let's go ahead and print some things here. So from the workbook, we can access or we can view, for example, all the different sheet names we might have available. So sheet one and sheet two. So our Excel file has two sheets. The name of those sheets is sheet one and sheet two. So we saw that this Excel file sheet or Excel file has two sheets, sheet one and sheet two. Now, if we were to start working here with this workbook, likelihood is that we're going to be working with the data that's currently active. Or sorry, we're going to be working with the worksheet that's currently active. So let's go ahead and use WB again and have a look at active to see what is the current active worksheet. So that's sheet 2. So let's just go ahead and change that. So WB.active. And then we can now change this to another worksheet. So how this is going to work, values starting from 0, left to right. So this sheet here is going to be a 0, integer 0. This worksheet is going to be referenced as worksheet 1, and so on and so on, if we had more worksheets. So if I were to change this to 0, for example, we see that the sheet 1 will be now activated. There we go. So the current active worksheet that we'd be working on would be sheet 1. So I can also grab the worksheet. So for example, if I just wanted to do some operations on a different worksheet, I could simply just refer to it by name. For example, let's go sheet 2, for example. And then from here, what I can now do is, I know basically I'm working from sheet 2. So let's just output that. Sheet title. So that will output the title referring to. Now I can then access that sheet through this sheet variable here. So if I now were to output that, it now outputs the sheet 2 title. And then from here, I can start grabbing information utilizing the sheet variable name here if I wanted to get some data from some cells within this sheet. So that's really the principles there of loading the worksheet. Hopefully it wasn't too quick. And then working with sheets, we saw that we can select, or we could at this point select multiple sheets if we wanted to, or refer to them through a variable, or we can change the active sheet that we want to work with. So now let's take a look at retrieving cell values from our worksheets. No doubt you've used Excel before. Here you probably already know that we can refer to cells or data in cells through, for example, this system here. At the top here we've got columns, A, B, C, D, F, etc. And on the left-hand side here we have numbers. So if I wanted to refer to this cell, I could use B3. That would then refer to this cell here. So I can utilize that to extract data from my worksheet. So here we've selected the sheet one. Passed it into this variable, and now we go ahead and select this cell. So this will return the cell object. So for example, B3, that's what we're trying to select. So let's have a look at that. You can see that's going to return the cell object here, cell sheet B3. Now, if we wanted to actually print out the value, let's just go ahead and extend here and include value, and then that will then actually return the value. In this case, it's a string, the name of the book, A Gentleman in Moscow, a novel. So just moving back here, let's go back to returning the object here. So this object is going to hold a lot of information which we can utilize potentially. So let's just go ahead and we'll store this. So let's go for new coordinates equals sheet. Let's just grab, for example, A1. Okay, so we're going to put the A1 object inside of this variable here called NC. So what we can now do, for example, is take NC and we can gauge some more information. So obviously one of them being the value. So we've grabbed the cell A1. Now we've printed out the value. We've got the value from this cell object. So what we can also do here, because we know that A1 here is in the corner here, this ID, let's just go ahead and just grab some more information. So for example, if you wanted to get information about the row. So this is row 1, which is correct. We can do the same thing here. For example, we can see what column this is in. So this is in column 1, row 1. And for example, we can get the coordinates from this in addition to that. So coordinates, and that would give us then the coordinate of this cell. So you can now see that we can use the coordinates to grab information, the cell object, and then in that object, we can then extract more information. So let's move on slightly, have a look at a different approach to selecting data. So we can select data utilizing the shell. So let's just go ahead and let's just grab this again, sheet 1. So we can now refer to sheet 1. through sheet. And now we can have a look or select data utilizing cell. So from here, we just need to specify what cell we want to access. So for example, we want to select row one and then column one. So that's going to return the cell object again. Now we can extend this, so outside of these parentheses here. So let's go ahead and type in value, so we can grab the value as per normal and all the other information that we've seen. So it might not be too often you are selecting individual cells, but it just adds to the story here. We're building up our knowledge slowly, moving now on to retrieving multiple values. So obviously it's probably more likely that you want to retrieve multiple values or a selection of values from your sheet. So let's have a look at some of the basics here. So we'll keep the sheet here active. We'll use print again just to output. So we know that, for example, earlier we learned an individual cell, we can access the information utilizing these coordinates, A1, etc. So we can also, for example, if I just selected A, that would actually give us the output of the A column. So that's also something, again, selecting a range of objects here. I can select the column through the reference, in this case, A. So in that respect, what I can now do is move this forward slightly and start kind of slicing. So if you're already familiar in Python to slicing, this is going to come, this is going to be second nature to you. But of course, if you aren't, and you are working with Excel data in this manner, it'd be well worth you kind of stopping at some point or later on, just having a look at Python slicing or slicing data with Python, just those principles. Although they might not map exactly across here, it'd be well worth you having a look at that. So for example, here, if I use a colon, so remember A is referring to the column name, so AC. So basically I'm going to extract here, as you'll see here, columns A, B, and C. So here, for example, I have all the cells from column A, A1, A2, A3, A4. This here we can see Bs, B1, B2, B3, and here we've got the Cs. So that gives me the opportunity to select different columns. So it's the same principle here for if I wanted to select rows. So for example, one is referring to row one here. You can now see I have A1, B1, C1. So now I'm returning all the cells from row one, etc. So same principles here. I can select a range, so 1 to 3. So there I'm going to return 3 rows. So A, B, and C. Yep. In this case, obviously it's 1, 2, and 3. So A1, B1, C1. A2, B2, C2, and A3, B3, and C3. So 3 rows. So you might prefer, and it can be a little bit more selective, we can utilize the iterrows function and the itercols function. So what we can now do, let's go ahead and just run a for loop. So for row in sheet dot, and here we can use the iterrow function. So what we can now do is just kind of specify, for example, the min row. So the minimum row is 1, and then the maximum can be, for example, 2. So I'm going to select row 1 and 2, and then I can kind of do the same thing again for the column. So min col equals, let's go for 1. And then the max column, we'll just go for 2. Okay, so what I can now do is just go ahead and print that out. Oof. Print row. So let's have a look at that. And you can now see that it has no attribute, it's a row. I've done something wrong here, it's rows. There we go. So here I can take a selection from my workbook. So remember here I'm selecting rows. So you can see here that I've got my first row, A1, B1, and then A2, B2. So I can do the same thing again here with columns if I prefer working with columns. So the same principles apply. So whether you select by columns or rows, it's just giving you that option depending on what you want to do with the data. Now you can go ahead, of course, if you want to. If we, for example, were to just select sheet rows, that would select all the rows in your workbook. And the same thing for column. So here we could lowercase columns, we could select all the columns. So that was just returning all the data, again, by columns or by row. So what we can do here in actual fact, if we prefer, let's just go back to it's a rows, just to control Z that. There are some other parameters that we can add here. One of them being values, values only. So that equals true. So that's going to return the values instead of the cell objects here. So we can retrieve the data. So hopefully now we've got the general grasp of grabbing data, consecutive data from our worksheet. Now let's convert that into a dictionary, a Python dictionary. Okay, let's go ahead and create a new dictionary. We're going to call this books equals empty dictionary. Okay, let's now go ahead and create a for loop. So for row in sheet dot iter rows. So we're going to use iter rows again function. So in here, we're just going to define what rows we want to select. Now I'm going to select from row 2 because I don't want the header. The header information is in row 1. So I'm not going to select or define a max row here. And we'll do the same for the column for now. So col equals min col equals 1. So starting from column 1. And then I do want the values only in this case. So values only equals true. Right, so that's selecting my range of data. So now what I want to do is I want to set up my index. So book ID equals row 0. So we get the information. So this here is going to select, for example, the index number. So 1, 2, 3 are the row number. So let's go ahead and now book equals. Now let's just define our information we want in our dictionary. So title data. So that's going to be found in row in the first or the second cell in the row. So the first cell in the row is 0. That's going to be the, if we just go back to our data, that's going to be the ID here. So here we're referring to cell kind of, or information 1. So that's going to grab this data, and this is going to be 2, and the author. So we get the title, and we go ahead and grab the author. So row in 2, so that's going to grab the author information. We're going to need a comma there. So that just grabs out the information, and then we go ahead and say books, and update our book dictionary, book ID, and then the index, and then the data. So that's going to be book. Right, so let's go ahead and print this out. So I'm going to use, let's just use JSON dumps. So books, let's give it a nice indent. Let's go for 3. Okay, so just make sure you import JSON. So that's just to kind of output the data. And let's go ahead now and give that a go. And there we go. So we've just selected the first 3 rows of our worksheet. You can see they've got the index, 1, 2, and 3, the title and the author. So I hope that gives you an initial insight. There's probably lots of questions now being, well, how do I select a range of information that's not adjacent to each other, for example? So those type of questions, I will answer those type of questions in a later tutorial. I just wanted to get the basic information out there to provide the scaffolding for us to now move forward. Any questions, leave them in the comments. Thank you very much for listening. Hopefully this was useful in some sort of way, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.